Hello students, in this video we will see different methods to check the tooth thickness. Various methods are recommended for the measurement of gear tooth. For example, the gear tooth caliper, a span gauging or a tooth span micrometer is used to measure the tooth thickness. Theoretically also we can measure the tooth thickness, the constant chord measurement or the measurement over rolls, or one more method, that is the tangent method, which is used to find out the tooth thickness. Now here the measurement with gear tooth caliper, how we take the measurement of gear tooth thickness with a gear tooth caliper. It is one of the most common method which is used and it is accurate. Now friends, before we move to this in detail, we'll also have a look with how does the two vernier scale for a gear caliper looks like. The vertical vernier gives the position of a blade which can slip up and down. I'll show you in the figure. You can see friends, this is a gear tooth caliper. It has two vernier scale. This is the main scale and this is the vernier scale. It is similar to that of how the vernier scale is being used. Here you can see clearly it is mentioned, this is the vernier, actually the main scale and the vernier scale. Both these can slide on left and in the topward portion. This is how the figure is showing, that how the gear tooth is held here. In this method, how do we calculate the thickness or width and height of the gear tooth? We'll show you. So let us understand this figure in detail first. So this is the pitch circle radius and this is the height h, the outermost, the face of the tooth and the base of the tooth. So this is the base circle, the pitch circle. Now the distance, this is the point C, this is the point E, this is the point D, this is the tooth angle theta, and it is theta, 2 theta, this is equal to 2 theta. This is the pitch circle radius from the center. Now if we move from this above figure, chordal thickness and chordal height, we need to measure it out. From the figure 7.8, AB, what is AB? You can see here, this is arc AB, it is lying on the pitch circle. AB is the width of the teeth and CD is the height of the tooth. Now AD plus BD means, if you see here, AD plus BD, that is equal to W, and AD is equal to BD. The distance from AD is equal to BD. So you can see here W, AD is equal to BD, therefore W is equal to twice AD. Now from triangle ADO, let us see which is triangle ADO. Here you can see angle D is 90 degree and angle O is theta. So if I take sine theta, that is equal to AD upon AO. I again repeat, AD upon AO. Therefore diagram, the AD is equal to AO sin theta, and that is AO is equal to R sin theta. So by rearranging, AD that is equal to AO sin theta, AO is equal to R sin theta. Now in angle AOD, theta is equal to 360 by 4n, where n is the number of teeth. Why we are taking here n 360 divided by 4? It means when two gears are oppositely meshing, n stands for number of teeth. So in one circle, the number of teeth total, how many divided by one teeth, but the opposite meshing teeth also is considered. So if we take it half, I'll show you here. Suppose this is the teeth, so this is the teeth of which we are measuring. So there is one more opposite teeth here. So if we consider entire 360 degree, the number of teeth is alternate. So in between, the distance which is considered between two teeth, it is again the same equivalent to the opposite teeth angle. So that's why we have taken theta, 1 theta, 2 theta, and similarly of other 3 theta and 4 theta of the opposite gear. So here the students gets confused that why they have taken 4. So that is clearly mentioned. So 360 by 4 by n, n is the number of teeth, so theta becomes 90 by 4 90 by n. So remember this value for tooth, it is always 90 by 4. Previously also we will, means later on we'll have this value. Now you can see AD is equal to R sin 90 by, substituting the value of AD in equation 1, we get W is equal to 2 into R sin 90 by n, and W is equal to D sin 90 by n, where D is the pitch circle diameter, that is equal to M into n. The height H can be calculated from that figure. OC is equal to, OC is equal to OE plus EC. But OE is equal to R NM by 2, and EC is equal to addendum, that is equal to modulo M. So OC is equal to N plus N by 2 plus M. This is equation 3, and from equation 4, OC is equal to OD plus DC. Again from triangle ADO, cos theta is equal to OD by R. Therefore OD is equal to R cos theta, rearranging the term, OD is equal to R cos 90 by N, that is equal to the value of R which we have received here, that is NM by 2 cos 90 by 2. Substituting this value, here substituting the value of OC and OD from the equation 3 and 5, in equation 4, yeah, OD and DC, we'll get NM by 2 plus M, that is equal to NM by 2 cos 90 by N plus DC. But CD here is the chord height, therefore DC is equal to H, that is equal to NM by 2 plus M minus NM by 2 cos 90 by N. So substituting H instead of DC, we get this equation. So this is the final equation to derive the H for vernier tool method. Thank you very much.